Hello, everybody, and welcome back to another episode of Conan, Exiled. We return, and in our quest, I know what we must do. Last we left off, we attempted to appease the god of Set. If you haven't seen that video, link will be in the description. Also, the giveaway is continuing. All you gotta do is like the video, leave a comment down below, let me know what you think of the video after you're done watching it, and make sure you're subscribed and know when more videos go up. But the god of Set, I don't know if we pleased him, because there was a guy here. I tried killing him with a sacrificial knife. Then he died of starvation and was eaten by the shrine. It was seriously amazing. Like, if you guys haven't seen it, it's ridiculous. But I don't know if that appeased him. But in the meantime, I do know how to appease him, I think. So if we go here, we go to the attributes, we can see the recipes we can learn. We're about to get the next level, by the way. That's going to be big. The XP grind is really going to be something we want to knock out. Some of the stuff that we want here, the main thing that we want is the Thrall Taker. This will allow us to get the bindings, the truncheon, and the lesser wheel of pain. The truncheon lets us knock people out. The bindings let us bring them, drag them around, and the wheel of pain lets us break the mind of them, aka tame them. That's how we go about taming. And I want to tame some goddamn thralls, or at least the equivalent of it. And so to do that, we got to get some XP. While we're at it, though, next time we get a level, I'm thinking we get the base building. We'll start building up a little base over here by the shrine and really kind of start doing a couple things like that. So, to succeed, like I said, we need to find ourselves. I thought that was a person. That was not. I think that might have been poop. I know this game had poop. We got to find things to attack and things to fight. Our best bet, probably going to be thralls. We do have the sacrificial knife there in our left hand. I don't know how good that's going to be in actual combat. But I do know over there that there is a barbarian encampment, and we do also have a bedroll over here. Now on the way, we're going to make sure to pick up some resources, just because I think that gets us a tiny bit of XP. And we should also get a campfire going, and then we should probably harvest up some meat. And then once we get the meat, we are going to want to, what is it? We're going to want to actually cook that up, so the whole starvation thing doesn't happen as much. Those guys, I've learned, they're pretty friendly. They're like gigantic turtles. What up, turtle? Oh, no, never mind. Not as friendly as I thought. Not as friendly. Oh, my God. He just broke my hand. Look at him. You bastard. I'm going to kill you. I got a sword. I don't even care. Ugh. Oh, I should probably have some armor on. Well, hopefully we kill this guy. Yes, we got him. Death to the turtle. Death to the turtle. Okay. Good news. Let's harvest as much meat as we can out of this guy. We get some hide. We get some flesh. Beautiful, beautiful. Let's hope that our health regenerates before our body realizes it's starving. And let's continue on. Now this game, I've been seeing some comments so far. Some of you guys, you're iffy about it. Some of you guys really like it. Some of you guys are eh. You know, it just seems kind of like Ark. You know, keep watching. Things don't start getting really interesting until we start. Because every survival game, when you think about it, it kind of starts out the same. Once you start getting to the higher level stuff, though, that's when things get interesting. That guy gave us like a lot of XP, too. I'm a fan of that. I want to go up in Vitality. Make sure we got a good pool of health. Looks like we go up in 12 every time that happens. And we got a recipe. And with that recipe, ooh, we could get the archer. That does cost 2 points, though. Okay. I think we want to get the stonemason so we can actually build a damn base. And then we can save up and probably get the archer. That's going to be good. I think that'll be good. Every time we get a level, I think we get 1 point. That's the way it should work. Don't quote me on that. So anyways, what we can do now is hopefully start getting some stuff to build. Over here in the recipes, we can do sandstone foundations. All we need is wood, and it should start a stone. Stone, luckily, is really not too hard to come by. You got your pickaxe, right? It's really going to be... These are some gigantic trees, by the way. I didn't even realize that. It's going to be really easy. All you got to do is find yourself some stone. You hold, you click on it. Hold up. There we go. Start breaking the thing. Server might be lagging a tiny bit. But at least on the Blitz server here, we get a huge amount of stone per hit, like 9, which round that up, that's 10. And then sometimes you get 12. So it averages out to like 10 per hit. So for every like second you hold down your mouse with the pickaxe, you are getting a lot of stone. Now the problem is that stone weighs a good amount. You can see our encumbrance going up. I'm going to steal these turtle legs and cook them up in a delicious fire, hopefully. One of those monstrosities known as turtles, or I call them turtles at least, see that. And I think we should be able to craft up 4 foundations. Beautiful. So as that's crafting, we are going to begin building our humble abode. Of course, over by our shrine. The shrine. I don't know what this residue does. That manifestation of zeal. I don't know what that is. but we get it every time we do something special. We can get a human heart. I'm kind of excited to get that, because then we can make an antidote. And antidotes are kind of our special thing for our religion, known of following Set, the gigantic freaking snake. That's kind of how he repays us. He's like, yo, dude, one of my snakes poison you? I got you, bruh. I got you. And I'm just like, thanks, Snake. You are such a cool dude. And he's like, yes, I am coolest dude. Now, I don't think that gave us too much XP. Even if it did, we need 7k to hit the next level. And it's gonna take a little while. But let us begin building our home. We're gonna build it. We'll build it right behind the altar. Why the hell not? You know, just nice and easy peasy. We'll make it a 3x3 for the time being. That way, you know, we'll be closer to Set. When we sleep, the Snek will be with us. I'm gonna refer to him he's either gonna be Snek or Set, or a combination of the two. As a heads up, I'm referring to the same guy, if you guys hear that. Those giant statues, they gotta mean something. Or they just look cool. I don't know. Oh, I hear something.
Hello.
Hello. Person. Oh, Krusty. Krusty the Clown. What's up?
Sir, there is no relation between us.
Ah, that's unfortunate. Anyways, what's up, dude? What you need?
I was just running around and I saw you there looking all lovely and basically naked. I thought, hey, look, there's a basically naked person over there.
Ah, I'm also attracted naturally to basically naked people. You know me so well.
I do. I've just met you, but I feel like we've known each other for minutes.
I would go as far to say maybe even 2 minutes.
Well, let's not get ahead of ourselves now.
All right, I would love to stay in chats, but I need to craft a campfire before I die of starvation. So, yeah.
That's a perfectly understandable explanation.
But hey, if you ever want to do some sacrificial deeds, if you ever want to, you know, worship the god of Set over there, let me know. I'll get you on the altar. I'll get you doing the good stuff. You know, it'll be great.
You know, it is funny you should mention such a thing. I worship that snake thing.
My man, let's freaking go. That's what I like to hear.
Yeah, worship snakes. They bite people and people are scared of them.
I like this guy. I like... Yes. Yes. I mean, you can stick around, but I do gotta get this campfire going. Soon. What else do I need? A stone? Yeah, okay, I gotta hit a rock a little bit. I don't know what he's gonna do. Whatever he does, though, he's friendly. He's a man of Set. And a man of Set, or a friend of Set, is a friend of me. So I'm liking this. Starvation is hit. Uh-oh, spaghetti frickin' oh. We're gonna get this campfire going in our base. We'll have it outside. You know, we'll to offer food to Set. We got the campfire. Where the campfire at? Where the campfire at? There it is. Let's plop that down there. Yeah, I don't know what this guy's doing. Do we still have our bed? Yeah, we still have our bed there. Yay! Let's interact. Let's pop all that flesh down in there. And then we got, like, some wood. Get 20. Okay, this time we're actually gonna hopefully be able to keep the frickin' wood before we get murdered by something. So we'll get 8 grilled steaks. Our food's going down pretty quickly. Pretty quickly. But yeah, it's good to know we're near such friendly people. And actually, a lot of people seem to be building by this southern river just because of the whole water situation. You need water to live. So word on the street is a lot of people are building down here. So that's going to be good. More people for me to abduct in my completely ethical ways. And more people to, you know, screw around with, have some fun. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm about to devour this steak. Oh, never eaten a steak in such a savage way. Jesus. Oh. Okay. Take things slow again. What were we doing? I think we were trying to build up. Oh, there's that person. I mean, who knows? Maybe he'll build by here, in which case, you know, I think he can use that shrine too. Hey man, so if you want to build over by here, that works, because then you could just use my shrine to the Snek God.
That is very generous of you. I don't know how you use the shrine to the Snek God, but I'm interested in it.
Alright, yeah, you can craft a sacrificial dagger, as you see. And then I think you need to be level 10 so you can successfully have the things to abduct people with. And then you abduct them, put them on there, and kind of sacrifice them. Fun times.
Ooh. I like the sounds of this abducting thing you speak of.
Yeah, it's going to be good. But I got to get some levels. I'm only like level 5. I need level 10.
down.
You know any good ways of getting some easy XP?
I have no idea. I've just been running around staring at trees for the most part.
Trees are fascinating.
They are, and they allow us the breath of life.
Damn it. There we go. Oh, that thing got repaired pretty quickly. Alright, yeah, so this guy's chill with us. That's awesome news. I like knowing the chill people are nearby. Makes me feel good about myself. Makes me feel good about my neighbors. A good neighbor is a happy neighbor. A happy neighbor, happy wife. Happy wife, happy life. Something like that. So maybe I'll marry him. Who knows? But before we get off into such distant plants, we are getting all the stones so we can continue building some foundations. You can see we're getting XP just from harvesting. So harvesting does get us XP. And then I want to see if crafting does. So we're at 534. Remember that number. Actually, we're about to go up anyway. So we get about 100 per sealed foundation. And the one thing that we're actually short on is stone. So we might actually not have enough stone in our area to do what we want to do. As weird as that sounds, that might actually be our shortage. We might have to start wandering around a little bit to get what we want. But I mean, I'm cool with just building the base. So as you can see, even on this accelerated gather server, as with like every survival game, it does take a little bit to, I just want to craft one. Yeah, it does take a little bit to kind of get started. We're not doing anything too crazy. Like I said, a little 3x3. We'll probably expand more. We can always like tear down a wall, make things bigger. This is kind of cool. You can actually build up. That is, was not expecting that. I can't build. This land's already claimed. Who the hell claimed it? What? Oh, him. All right, well, unfortunately, it seems that our land is we're gonna have a weird shape to our land. I mean, we can kind of like build around like that. You know, it'll somehow buff out. So yeah, I'm just gonna go ahead and gather stone for a good amount here. And I will talk to you guys when we got a little bit more. I wanna at least get maybe, what, one level? That's asking for a lot. I think killing things might be our better bet. All right, we'll go, I'll go ahead, gather up some more stone, and we will begin building up some walls, and we'll at least build a formidable, not formidable, a respectable base before we head on out and start doing other shenanigans. Sound good? Sound like a plan. Talk to you guys in a sec. All right, everyone, so I got ourselves quite a good amount of stuff. We're gonna be crafting up a couple more foundations. We might finally actually be getting to be short on wood instead of everything else we've been short on. We also are a little bit over-encumbered. Just a tad. There we go. We can finally move again. So the encumbrance system is a lot kinder than arc. You don't actually slow. You don't become encumbered until you actually hit your weight limit. You have no clue how much I love that, being someone who, used to play a lot of arc. Still play a good amount of arc, but as someone who just plays survival, that's so nice. I thought I was recording when I placed this stuff down. I don't know which part I wasn't and which I was, but I will show you guys the situation. We got the door facing that way. We're incorporating the shrine into our building. It's gonna be very cool. Maybe we'd have a roof over it. That'd be kind of cool. And what we can do, as you can see, we can expand out this way now, but only right here. So I don't know if I'd really want to expand out there. We're just gonna go flat out. We can also go this way. Of course we can. Of course we can. That only makes sense. But we're gonna make our expansion, choose to make it this ways, and then we're gonna continue crafting up a couple more of these. Not too many. I'm thinking like 4 ought to do it, and then we will have these continue going here. We'll have one more. We'll do some walls, and we're gonna have this be, maybe this will be like the 3x3 area of our base. You guys can kind of see what I'm going for, right? So that's kind of like the beginning hallway. Then this will be the meat of the base. And then we can continue putting down some of these walls because I had a good amount of these left over. So I'm gonna go ahead. You know, I just wanna give you a little status update on the base. And then after the base is done, shouldn't be too long. I'm thinking we head over there once we got our bed down, see if maybe some barbarians wanna pick a fight. I'm thinking that's gonna be a good plan. So in the meantime, stay awesome. Don't go anywhere. And someone is approaching me, or she's somewhere, Lady Weasel. Oh, I don't know. I'll let you know if something develops out of that, but I'll talk to you in a bit. All right, everyone, welcome back. I've been doing a good amount of harvesting. Also, fun fact, since we are by these little nests where turtles would normally be laying, a cool thing about that, right, is that we can actually, if I go to my campfire here, we should be able to cook these eggs, and I got a lot of eggs. Shellback eggs, there we go. A large nutritious meal stolen from a shellback thing. I don't know if this will work. Let's try it. No, it won't work because there's no crafting cube. But I think we can eat them raw. Low grade ingredient consumable. A large nutritious meal stolen from a nest. So I guess we can't scramble them. Maybe we gotta like do something special. But we got the rest of the expansive parts that I wanted for. We should be able to at least encase our place here. And voila, you can see we got a nice little hefty base. We'll probably have the staircase be kind of over here. This might be way more walls than I thought that I needed. Well, that's kind of awkward, but yeah, that is way more walls than I actually needed. We'll do something about that, but this is going to be our Roman space initially. Then we can get these sandstone ceilings. We got those right there. We almost have another level. Yeah, we're like 1,000 away. That's how much I've been grinding, which is good. You know, we're kind of getting that out the way. Failed to place. What? Why am I failing to place this? Is there a reason for that? Do I need like some? Okay, no, now it's going. Okay, that's weird. And we got a whole ton. We got 12 ceilings to be exact. That ought to be enough. Crazy person outside potentially. I like the system's weird. It says like sometimes I can't place. I think if you're too far, that might be it. Because right now we aren't having too much trouble doing it, so that's good. Now I don't know how the staircase is gonna work. That is one thing that kind of has me like, how'd that work? So hopefully we can figure that out. I need like probably 60 more stone, but we got this going. And if we take a peek here, we did get another level. Let's go up in strength, make sure we keep getting stronger. And when it comes to building armor, that might be good. Better shields, good investment. But I really do want to kidnap people. That's one thing that I'm so excited to do. Pillars, I think that helps. Stairs, there we go. So that's one thing we can learn at level 7. I think we are level 7? Or no, we're level 6. Okay, so at this point we start getting 2 points per level. That's handy. So in a level, we'll get the stairs. So we will leave kind of this last row open for the time being. But still, really nice stuff. I'm liking this. I'm liking this. We can, however, get something new. I'm thinking maybe, you know, maybe archery. That's a good investment. Let's hit it, baby. And then what do we need to become a cold-blooded archer? Just craft up some twine and some stones? Not even too shabby. We should be able to get some twine pretty easy. Never mind, we got 4 twine. All right, I'm gonna do some more harvesting. All right, everyone, we return. And I picked up some of my stuff, and you can see a beautiful look at our beautiful base. That's how it's looking so far. We'll expand the floors up, though, so it does look nicer. But for now, there we have our humble abode. And honestly, it looks awesome. Maybe not from that angle, but from any angle where you can kind of see the shrine. And then you can also see the base behind it. It looks very freaking cool. I can't wait to do some sacrifices outside and all that jazz. But I did want to show this off before we headed out. So yeah. All right. And we're back. We got the last of these open. Like I said, I'm just going to leave this last little row here open. Sure, someone might hop in or something. If they do, good for them. But I just do want to have that open so we can hopefully be able to just have stairways up to the second floor. Because we're not done building. Our house is going to get higher. Don't even worry about that. But we got the necessary materials to craft up a hunting bow and craft up some flinthead arrows before ultimately getting... I think we still have our bedroll, but we can get a tunic. We can get some pantalones. We can get some feet. And we can just overall probably... We'll go get one more thing too as we armor up and prepare. Prepare to move out. Transformers, we're about to roll the hell out, man. Before we do that, but we're on a mission. We got a sacrificial dagger. We got this thing. Sword. That's what it's called. It's a sword. And we're gonna go and we're gonna beat some ass over this way. Yeah, as you can see. Now, I don't know how to get up there, though. I thought there was maybe a land bridge. There isn't. We're gonna have to cross some rivers. We're gonna see how this battle goes. If we can take out these thralls, maybe like one at a time. Get through here. I wanna take out this thrall. Assert my dominance. What up, thrall? How you doing? There we go. Ugh. He doesn't seem too keen on fighting. Ow. Ow. Okay, he's doing some damage. Ow. Ugh. Ow, damn, he's a strong one. How is he staying alive? Oh, you're gonna, yeah, celebrate. Good idea, dude. There we go. Down he goes. He was a toughie. How much XP we get for that? No clue how much we got, but hey, it's better than nothing. What's he gonna have, like plant fiber on him? No clue, because I hit loot all. Still didn't pick up the stuff though. He's got a campfire here. Can't even use it. This guy, he doesn't have anything. Okay. Our journey continues. What are these? Little cattails? Aloe leaves. Oh, look at that. I think we should be able to craft up some medicine once we get a high enough level for those. That'll be handy. Bedroll. Overlapping. Yeah, I don't know how these work. I will put this here. Just kind of scatter them about. I think when we die, we can maybe pick from the map where we want to respawn. I haven't actually died when I've had a bedroll yet. All right, well, maybe perfect opportunity. We try to craft up the hunting bow. Yeah, all we need is some branches and hide. We still need the hide. Oh, speaking of hide, a hyena's about to attack us. A hyena! Haha! Alright, we'll take this thing out pretty quick. Hopefully. There we go. It's dead. Got some hide off it. Give me the hide. Okay, just nothing but flesh. God damn it. Not what I wanted. Oh, hello, turtle. I think he's attacking us. Yeah, turtle not happy. Turtle not happy. I don't care about turtle things, though. Turtle goes down whether he likes it or not. Ugh. I do like the third-person view in this game, though. It is nice. Can we take him out before he kills us in one more hit? Holy crap. Too close for comfort. Give me some hide. One more. Nah, we still need a little bit of hide. Damn it. That dude... Oh, no. Okay, well, you know what? This might be the end. This might be the end. Yeah, this might be it. Damn it. The hyenas, man. They're so... Oh! It's not. Our story continues until the starvation hits, which is going to be very, very soon. Do we have any other food? Handful of insects. Use a couple of those. I just want... And a couple eggs. Use those. No food poisoning? No food poisoning. Hell yeah. Beautiful. We got everything we need. I think the bow is realistic. Okay, so while we calm down a little bit here... That's a gigantic spider! And a rhinoceros? Oh. Okay, maybe I'm not ready for this. I will still try, but... I'm kind of having second thoughts here. Oh no, the spider's coming, crippling poison. Yeah, we're done. There is no hope for us. We're getting cripplingly poisoned. Oh my god. Spider, don't attack me. I've done nothing. I think he wanted the hyena. Maybe. Holy crap. Wait, is that poison still hurting us? That spider's coming after us hard. Okay. We gotta try. What did I just hear? What up, spider? He's not smart enough to get- Oh my god, he can shoot at us? Okay, that's not fair. That's not fair at all. Giant spiders are a thing? Okay. We got our hunting bow. Thank you. We should be able to craft up the arrows now. Thank you. I say we try and shoot this thing from above. That might be our best bet. Yeah, because... Okay, we're getting some stuff back. We do have another point here. No clue when we got that. We got it. We'll keep on going up in... Yeah, let's go up in strength. I don't know if that rhino is going to be mad at us. One thing I'm worried about. And we got the arrows. Where do we put the arrows? There. Okay. So, no ammo. Does it have to be in here? No ammo. What? Do I have to load it single? One by one? Nope. There we go. Alright, we got this. There we go. Ow. That thing's still hitting us pretty hard. Down goes the spider! Dude! Hell to the yes. See you later, spidey boy. What did you have on you? Oh my goodness. What's, feral flesh and itchor. Oh, what's it? A hyena. Dude, I wasn't ready for this. I wasn't ready for this. No. Sword. Sword. Okay. I don't think it knows to attack us yet. Okay, good. We got up here. Let's take this thing out. Oh, it might be a smart one. Yeah, I think it's a smart hyena. There we go. Boop. Come on. Draw the arrow. There we go. It's a brutal world out here, but we're doing pretty okay. Once you get the bow, things really start to get a lot better. Alright, we covered some XP. I wonder if we could get out of there, dude. If we could get some better armor, maybe get a couple people with bows, I think we could stage an assault on one of these camps. Pretty... Maybe not easily, but realistically, I think that's the right word for it. We could realistically do something like that. At least the entrance is empty. We're doing some forward scouting. Dude, a full barbarian camp. Look at that. Beautiful. Also, if you hit Alt-C, you can actually look at things the more beautiful way. How do I undo this, by the way? I have no clue. Uh-oh. Well, that's no bueno. Let's hope let's hope I remember what's what. What was that, 7? Yeah, 7's this. They got a bongo. They got everything. Looks like there's 1 fighter. 2 fighters. 3 fighters. A lot of fighters. Okay. Oh my god, they got arrows! Damn! That dude's accurate. These guys are good. They're good. Nope, missed that shot. Maybe it hit. I heard someone grunt. Where is he? Oh! Come on. At least I got one of them. Do I still have ammo? No ammo. No ammo. Okay. Take out the sword. That's the dagger. Sword! We fight for our right to party! Oh, these guys... They worship Yogg, do they? By the sounds of it, that's what it is. Alright, let's, Oh no, didn't want to do that. I just wanted to harvest the damn thing. I can't even access my inventory. I don't know how to undo this, by the way. Can I, maybe just Z? Alt-Z? Oh, there we go. No? Oh, I guess it was just lag. Okay, this is not good, not good. I want to fight these guys. I want to take them out. You will fall at my hands! That guy's got the shield. Look at him. He's a tough one. It's nighttime. Our sword broke. Okay, we gotta repair that. Lickety split. This guy, look at that. That's a Darfy fighter too. He's a lot stronger. And they're still shooting arrows. And I fall. Well, damn. You know, I can't complain. That was a good run. That was a good run. I'm happy with that. Sure, we lost a couple things. I don't think it'll be too bad, though. We ought to get it back. Yeah, these guys worship Yogg, it seems. I don't know where we're going to respawn. Do we get to choose the bed, or... We respawned here. I don't know where this is. This is not... Okay, well, I'm going to wander my way back home. We are so far away from home. Why don't we get to respawn on the bed? I don't know. I'm going to wander my way back home. I hope you guys did enjoy. If you did, let me know, hit that like button, leave a comment down below, and hopefully I will figure out how to properly respawn where I should be respawning. So that's kind of weird. But the series is going well. I can't wait to see where it goes. And fun things are coming. They really are. I'm thinking next episode, hopefully if I can get some grinding out of the way, there'll be some thralls to break in. I'm excited for that. That's going to do it for me as a army of pissed off people chase me. I actually don't care if I die, because I can respawn closer. So yeah, thank you guys all the time for watching. Have yourselves a fan-freaking-tastic day, and I will talk to you in the next one. See ya.